England manager Don Revie was in attendance as a powerful Liverpool side, featuring players like Emlyn Hughes and Kevin Keegan, were the opponents in this match from 1975. Arsenal proving once again how strong they were in front of their own fans at Highbury.
An Arsenal kickoff, attacking the goal to our right. Red shirts with white shorts, Liverpool, of course, in their chain strip of white shirts with black shorts. Here's Brian Hall. Arsenal, who've already beaten Liverpool at Anfield, which could well go down as one of their best performances of the season so far. They won it 3-1 and Alan Ball scored a couple. And Liverpool out of the cup and now desperate for every point they can get, even on a very difficult pitch like this. One would hope that they attack a lot. An advantage played by the referee there because Keegan was clearly pushed, but in the end there was no advantage to Highway. Here's Phil Thompson playing it now for Alec Lindsay. Again in towards Keegan, a small man who might keep his balance a little better than most here. Callaghan now. Phil Neal, man they bought from Northampton Town. And Story back, as you'd expect, in a deep defensive position and not being as positive as he usually is. Jimmy Rimmer. Scored two goals at Anfield, and indeed a goal at Coventry last week. Lindsay and Keegan, the ball just in play. Strong challenge again by Simpson, and a fair one. Highway will take the throw for Liverpool. Here's Keegan. That looked like a little nudge in the back of Keegan, and it was right on the edge of the box, and Keegan is saying, you could probably see him there, to the referee, I was pushed. But it's a throw no more for Liverpool, and here's Keegan again. A deft little flick over his head there, and now Cormac has come just wide! Cormac wears the number five, but loves nothing more than a spring from midfield and have shots at goal like that. Nice deft work by Keegan, a little flick on, and it was just wide of that far post. Side against Keegan. Arsenal's free kick. Pat Rice will take it. Hit firmly towards Kidd, in fact too firmly, but it goes off a Liverpool defender, no danger to them. Toshek taking rather a rough handling there. If anything, I suppose that's the first time that Harold Davey hasn't played the advantage to perfection. Now Cormac, in fact, not taking it from the right position, and the referee absolutely right on that occasion as well. But he has played the advantage so well, Harold Davey. A free kick then to Liverpool, but by now Arsenal got everybody back behind the ball, bar Brian Keane. Hughes with the free kick. Hit again, inevitably towards Toshek, gets in there. McNabb having trouble getting it away. Toshek gets it in again. Lindsay with the shot just over. Again, the threat of Toshek in the air, setting it all up again. When the ball came out to him, he had a shot. That was only half cleared, and Lindsay had, if anything, an even more powerful shot, and that just cleared the crossbar. Lindsay scored three times this season. Nearly made it four. A long one away there by Matthews. He was going to ruck the referee no end there. He thought the free kick was Liverpool's way, but the referee felt that Toshak was in fact backing in on Mancini. So anger turned to that super smile. K Kidd winning it in the air, but only to the convenience of Cormack. Toshak. Onside is Keegan. But he couldn't get the better of Simpson, although Keegan claims that that was handball by the Arsenal number six. Matthews now. Thompson to Cormack. Keegan is offside at the moment, but it's with Toshak. It's all right now. So too is Brian Hall, but so too was Peter Simpson for Arsenal. Oh, that wasn't a good pass, though. Here's Neil, played forward firmly. There could be some dodgy areas and some dodgy things happening on the edge of these penalty areas, where the ball is getting stuck quite a bit. Rice. Good pass there for Ball, and nicely taken by him. Played first time here for Matthews. It'll come back for Ball again, as that was the intention. And a foul by Phil Thompson gives Arsenal a free kick. So it's with Ball. Played in again towards Brian Kidd. Story is in there too. Now Toshak. Story up there. Now Brady. Chance to cross in towards Kidd, played back for Armstrong. Oh, Kidd now, Ball! Yes, and a ball! 1-0 to Arsenal! So Alan Ball does it again. He killed off Liverpool up at Anfield. He scored last week at Coventry. And this week, in many ways, a very similar goal as the ball comes across to him. And from a very narrow angle indeed, he manages to thread it home, 1-0 to Arsenal. So Ball now takes his tally up to 8, and Arsenal get the first vital breakthrough. Arsenal's Ball. Now that's plenty for the crowd to shout about. Cormack. Callaghan, and now Rice with Highway after him. Now it's with Armstrong. Hughes getting in first and getting in fairly. Lindsay playing it forward. Ball. Well, Lindsay went in hard there, so too did Hughes, in spite of a knock in the back, and he found Brian Hall. Here's Highway. Keegan in there, and now it's with Brady. Ball screaming for the ball in the middle of the field, and finally getting it. McNabb. Well, there really has been quite a comeback for Alan Ball this season. Comeback for Alan Ball this season. I know Don Revie was so impressed the last time he saw him play here, and in fact brought him into the England squad for the Portugal game. And Ball has done a lot to impress Don Revie today as well. McNabb forward for Kidd. Brady wanting it, Matthews right up there. Oh, absolutely caught in the mud. But that wasn't, and that goes beautifully straight to Highway for Liverpool now. Deep towards Toshak. Oh, and that was a nice header by Toshak too, because he knew Hall was behind him. Keegan right in there. Oh, and Mancini got that one away. What a jump by Keegan though. Played back again for Callaghan. And now it's with Lindsay. Both sides really setting about these conditions and really trying their best to conquer them. And for the most part succeeding. Here's Hall again for Liverpool. Played it again towards Keegan, and that time it goes behind for the goal kick. So Mancini did well deep in defence there for Arsenal, but it was also a tremendous header at the far post by Kevin Keegan. So Rimmer with the kick cross. Thompson winning that one in the air. There's Lindsay. And an offside. Playing this offside well, Arsenal. And maybe it's a gamble that's worth playing a little more in these conditions, because it's so difficult for players to run when they do get clear. A push by Kidd and a free kick to Liverpool. In injury time at the end of the first half. Arsenal have not beaten Liverpool here since 1970, but there, this one priceless goal in the lead. As the whistle goes for half-time, and Don Revie goes away, impressed, I would have thought, with the way both sides have tackled these difficult conditions, and impressed above all by the verve and the energy yet again by that number 8, Alan Ball, the man who's put Arsenal into the lead. But a half-time score here at Highbury reads Arsenal 1, Liverpool 0. We'll be right back.
Wicked goals.
All the way to the World Cup finals.
Wicked chat.
Eye gouging, drug taking, blood letting, Mickey taking, pile driver.
Absolute pile driver.
500 of the wickedest goals you'll ever see. And
the umpire strikes back.
Great goals, two great premiers.
Two teams do battle over ESPN's classic archive.
What a wicked combo for Wicked Wednesdays. Every Wednesday from 10 on ESPN Classic.
There was a town held captive by an evil fuel pump. It fed on people's hard-earned money. But along came the Michelin man, who reminded them the right tire changes everything. And with fuel-efficient tires in place, that evil fuel pump wasn't so evil anymore. Michelin Energy Saver can help save up to 80 litres of fuel. Michelin.
What do you think? Isn't she a beauty?
And what's the insurance going to be on that?
Go compare! Go compare! You can be sure when you insure through Go compare! You get the load down so costs can go down, and you'll thank your stars that you went to Go compare!
Good sound system.
Yes, you'll thank your stars that you went to Go compare!
In Guilin, China, fishermen use local experts to help them catch more fish. At HSBC, we use local investment experts to help your money achieve its potential. So world selection is available as a tax-efficient ISA.
EvoStick technology brings you Anti-Germ, the sealant that helps protect against infection. 1 hour shower, the sealant that repels water in just 1 hour. And White for Life, the sealant that resists black mold. EvoStick, the power of technology.
This Tuesday, buy any medium or large pizza from Domino's, and we'll deliver you another pizza absolutely free. Domino's 2 for Tuesdays, giving them away.
What if there was a better way to see the world? Take your viewing experience to a whole new level with full LED. LG Infinia LCD TV with full LED technology. Now 3D ready.
To fly or not to fly, that is not the question. Whether it is nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against a sea of troubles, and by opposing, end them, revive, revitalize. No more! And buy this elixir to know we... And the rest is silence, it seems. William Shakespeare. Genius does suffer without Red Bull.
back to Highbury then. Liverpool have changed into some nice clean white shirts. And now we'll be attacking the goal to our right. In fact, they've had a good record in London so far this season. They've won twice at Chelsea 3-0 and at Queen's Park Rangers 1-0. But here they are, this one goal down. Now Armstrong. Callaghan's header. Simpson coming in fast. Well, he waited, and Brady had all the brashness really of his youth to take it off the experienced campaigner. Matthews, what a good game he's had. And McNabb now sending Story on his way. Nice little ball there played for Bob McNabb. There's the cross again. Oh, and Clements was in all sorts of trouble. Ball with a shot just over. And it was deflected there by a Liverpool defender. And there's another corner for Arsenal, and ball getting in on the end again of that Arsenal move. Left foot shot that time. A deflection that sends it over. Ball with the corner. Towards Brian King. And Brady with the shot just wide. Much better stuff by Arsenal. For the first half hour of the game, it looked as though they could hardly raise a shot. And now, certainly as Liverpool start to come forward, they are beginning to exploit one or two little gaps in defence. And there's the man who's doing the organising for them, Alan Ball. Rice making no bones about that sort of clearance. Kidd having quite a maul there with Hughes. Again, good refereeing, playing the advantage, although in the end there was none for Arsenal. Highway. Can he get the better of Rice? It's still with Highway. This could be very dangerous. Oh, and Rimmer did so well. Highway, one of those lovely runs of his, and he tried to thread it past Rimmer, and Rimmer was down on it like a flash. Ball down and injured, and now it's now for Matthews. A penalty. Lindsay brings down Matthews. The referee has no hesitation. And Alan Ball, who's at the far end of the field, is the man who normally takes the penalties. I wonder if he's fit enough to. There's Ball. Matthews went through. Was pulled down by Lindsay. Now, could Ball make it his second goal and the second for Arsenal? Can he beat Ray Clements? This could be the killer goal, and the responsibility is with Ball and Clements. Yes! Coming, but it's the work that Alan Ball has done right across the field for Arsenal this afternoon that has really been as responsible as anything for Arsenal's happy position at the moment. So Toshak and Liverpool now with so much to do. McNabb getting it away. Neil heading it down neatly here for Callaghan. Touch on that time, and it's a throw for Liverpool, who won this game last year 2-0 when Emlyn Hughes scored and John Toshak scored the goals. And there's a quite simple catch by Jimmy Rimmer. Too many happy days this season for Bertie Mee up on the left there, but this must at the moment be one of them. Arsenal want to bring on their substitute, Trevor Ross. His first game in league football. He's played in a friendly. And Alan Ball, the hero with both these goals. And we felt before half-time that he had a chest pain. Somewhere on his ribcage, he goes off. Ross comes on, but just listen to the applause for Ball. Cormack, stopped by Mancini, and here's Ross. Armstrong. Ross is available for him. Oh, well, he got a bit excited there. Manchester lad, or at least a Lancashire boy. Played in one or two friendly games on the continent for Arsenal, but this is his first league go. Had a couple of chances to cross that. Mancini and Toshak, and the fellow, of course, who in the end was the difference between the two sides, not on the field at the moment, scorer of both the Arsenal goals, Alan Ball, one in the first half and a penalty in the second half. Applause all around Highbury for the whole Arsenal side, not least for Jimmy Rimmer there, who brought off one or two tremendous saves, as indeed did Ray Clements, and that's where Jimmy Rimmer's going now, the handshake of the goalkeepers. A fine afternoon's football at Highbury, which leaves us with a final scoreline that reads Arsenal 2, Liverpool 0.
I hope you've enjoyed our latest instalment of Sports Classics. Join us again for another trip down memory lane.
We've got more great action coming your way right after the break. You're watching ESPN Classic. We hope you like it here.
At B&Q, because we do it for less, you do it for less.
Get our lowest priced Derbyshire paving slabs for just £164 each. Or this eight-piece garden furniture set for, you might want to sit down, only £99.
You can do more with your garden for less at B&Q.
Daddy, where was that?
If everything you loved was taken away...
I need to know!
How far would you go to find the truth? With 800 free Microsoft points at HMV. Splinter Cell Conviction. Out now on Xbox 360.
You're on Pandora.
Up a bit, down a bit, slowly, just there.
Oh, and buy new brake pads or shoes, and we'll replace them for free for as long as you own the car.
That's wonderful. Thank you, Michael.
It's Derek. It doesn't matter, but... Yeah.
The Sunday Times Rich List, out this Sunday.
From hotels to B&Bs, to country houses to castles, all for less than you'd expect at laterooms.com.
Can we get a Pepsi Max?
You'll have to play us.
Where's the pitch?
Hang about, this is a breakfast show, not an 11's show.
No, Johnny, this happens to be a delicious new Belvita breakfast biscuit, a totally new way of having breakfast.
Biscuits for breakfast. Whatever next? Marmalade for lunch?
New Belvita breakfast biscuits are made with whole grain and are specially designed for breakfast. They will regularly release carbohydrates over 4 hours as part of a balanced breakfast.
Does this mean you get to talk more than you normally do?
New Belvita breakfast biscuits specially designed for breakfast.
At B&Q, get a lowest-priced corded grass trimmer for just £9.98.
You can do it for less at B&Q.
Would you have been so successful if you hadn't been so handsome?
I don't know. I think if I looked like Joe Frazier, I wouldn't care and just keep walking into punches like he did. See, Joe Frazier, he's so ugly, his face should be donated to the Beowulf Wildlife.